We are right in the middle of the Audi Digital Summer Tour. I'm Kati, I'm your host, and this is your daily live show. Today, I have a studio guest with me, which I'm really, really excited to talk to. So we're just going to take it really short in the beginning. As you know, the Audi Summer Tour, unfortunately, is not able to be held in person this year. But don't you worry, we have brought you up close and personal to your FC Bayern stars, giving you exclusive content, and hopefully you've enjoyed it so far. All the content we have provided you with so far, you can find on the FC Bayern platforms. And if you want to participate, ask questions to my studio guests, then please do so and use the hashtag AudiFCBTour. Yesterday, I was able to talk to FC Bayern legend Roy Mackay. He was also part of our goal voting. We will see if he won that against David Alaba yesterday. Then also, Javi Martinez gave a surprise call to a Chinese fan, and I was able to chat with exactly that fan early on today, so you will get a chance to meet him later. And Manuel Neuer took a ride with the brand new Audi e-tron, picking up Javi Martinez and Lucas Hernandez, and we will have that for you as well. But it's time to introduce you to my studio guest. I am 100% sure that you have heard his voice before, as he is the announcer at the Allianz Arena. Welcome, Stefan Lehmann.
Thank you, Kati. Thank you for the invitation. It's a pleasure for me to be here. Thank you.
It's a pleasure to have you here. I'm sure all the FC Bayern fans in the world at least have heard your voice once or twice before.
Maybe my voice, yeah, that's right. Because Tor in der 21. Spielminute now for about, yeah, approximately 25 years.
25 years. Yeah. And as you told me, I asked him, how many games did he miss? Can you please tell us?
No match. I missed no match.
So you...
I was announcing each single match from 1996 in August, I think it was the first one, till today.
That is amazing. Do you know how many goals?
No. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
I can
remember.
Find out, maybe.
I can remember some goals. Of course, the fastest goal of Roy Mackay, you mentioned already, after about 9.7 seconds, it was against Real Madrid in the Champions League. I remember this. It was in 2007 and a few more, but not exactly the exact number. Mm-hmm.
As people know your voice, we want to know more about you. Tell us a little bit about yourself and, of course, about your job.
Oh, okay. I do this for 25 years now, and approximately 25 years. And normally I'm a host in the radio and television stations also. But when the FC Bayern asked me, because I'm a member for about 35 years now, my member number is 1,745 right now. And yes. And when the FC Bayern asked me, hey, you're a well-known radio host in Bavaria, would you like to make the stadium voice for us? And of course, you are one of our members. I was like, hey, really? They asked me? Yeah, coming from the Südkurve, the famous Südkurve in the stadium, in the Olympic Stadium in Munich. And they were asking me to do this. And of course, I said yes. And I do this for 24 years now, really with pleasure. It's a pleasure. It's an honor to have this job, because in my opinion, I'm a, how can I say, in German you say Bindeglied. It's a connecting link, mm-hmm. you know, between the club and the sponsors and, of course, the fans. Mm-hmm. And, of course, you need somebody to say hello to the people. You need somebody to announce the lineup and the goals. And so if I can do this for the fans, for the club, the common experience, yeah, let's have a big party together in a stadium, mm-hmm. and then it's a pleasure for me, and I enjoyed it today.
Mm-hmm. We already received some fan questions for you, actually, and one of them being, what was your favorite match at the Allianz Arena?
That's a really hard question. There were many, but my favorite match in the Allianz Arena, I remember the match where Robert Lewandowski scored 5 times in between, I think it was 10 minutes mm-hmm. or 11, 12. It was against Wolfsburg. Mm-hmm. Robert did this amazing job. And Pep Guardiola was the coach at this time. And I remember the face of Pep Guardiola looking, what is happening here? It's incredible. And that was, for me, it was a normal match in the DFB Pokal, I guess. But that was, for me, outstanding, because mm-hmm. I will never experience such a match again, I'm sure.
Mm-hmm. And your favorite moments? You had, you know, the chance to celebrate a lot of moments.
Yes, you know, Kati, it's I hosted, for example, 5 Champions League finals. I've been to Barcelona 99 against Manchester United. For me, it's the mother of all losing, really. And 2 years later in Milano, in Milan, yeah, mm-hmm. the win of the Champions League against Valencia was amazing. But I think 2013, when Arjen Robben did the 2-1 against Borussia Dortmund at the Wembley Stadium, I think that's in my brain, in my head, one of the most amazing moments. And favorite moments here.
Okay. Well, you know, there's something happening right now that hasn't happened before due to this corona situation. Yeah. Yeah. The team was unable to go in person to China for this tour. So yeah. We're doing the Audi Digital Summer Tour. What do you think of it?
Yeah, that's the best we can do. You have the decision. It's the pandemic worldwide. Mm-hmm. So to do nothing is nothing. To do a digital tour is a digital tour. And I don't know if my friends in Canada, in Montreal, Steve, or my friends from the Toronto Südkurve, I met all the years before. I think it's now they have lunch in Canada. It's about a few minutes past 1 in midday.
Yeah.
So enjoy your lunch, guys. And hello. I think that's the best opportunity to do something for the fans, to show how Bayern Munich is handling this extraordinary situation. Mm-hmm. And we have to do all the best. Mm-hmm. I'm sure it will go on next year. Or I don't know exactly. I only can hope it. But I think it was a very good idea that together with Audi, our friends from Audi, we are doing this digital tour so that our friends in Asia, in China, or in the United States of America, mm-hmm. Canada, and where they are, they can take part of Bayern Munich in these days. Mm-hmm. And your show, of course, each evening. Yeah, yes. That's perfect.
But you had a chance to travel with the team to a lot of places, of course. Yeah. And you were also in China last time in 2017. And we have a little video clip of you doing a very special moment with the Chinese fans.
Really?
Let's have a look.
Und hier ist die Mannschaftsaufstellung des FC Bayern München.
Actually wearing the same shirt.
Yeah, it's my favorite shirt, you know. Now, it's the vintage. It's a vintage FC Bayern. I like it very much, but it's not the same T-shirt as 2017.
Okay. But just tell us a little bit. What is favorite memory, you know, when you go to do things like that? Do you have a favorite memory?
Yes, especially this moment here, I remember exactly. Mm-hmm. It was, of course, this, it was very hot on this day, very hot in China, and do this, the lineup together with the Chinese fans. And I remember especially one, we did fan zones before the match. Mm-hmm. I've been to a fan zone together with Miroslav Klose. Mm-hmm. And I remember exactly, it was amazing. It was a really big party. Miroslav Klose is who's now one of our co-coaches. And he's such a big hero in Asia. All the fans loved him. And it was screaming like a big pop star is going on stage. I can remember, really. It was all these impressions, you know. Kati, that will always be in my head, in my brain. You cannot forget these moments.
And one of those impressions is when we do the special Paulana events. Tell us a little bit about the atmosphere there.
Yeah, Paulana was always joining the summer tours, of course, and there were really perfect organized events. We always have been in the Paulana, special Paulana treffs, yes, in Wirtshaus, you know, together with hundreds of American or Canadian fans, or of course in Shanghai also. And I remember they have really good ideas at Paulana. I remember a grill barbecue challenge between Giovanni Elba as a legend and actual topical player Niklas Süle. Mm-hmm. Oh, what's that? Where's that?
We have footage of you.
Okay, yeah. That
in was Miami, I believe.
Yeah, no? Together with Lothar Matthäus right over here. Okay. Yes. No, there was a... That was a big...
the barbecue, yeah.
That's it. Yeah, really. We had so much fun there. Giovanni and Niklas, they have to grill meat and then... how can I say? You have to drink the right beer to the meat. Yeah, of course, there's a difference between the beers of Paulana and Niklas. I would recommend for this burger, please, white beer. It was a very, very good event. Only a few fans. It was a quite familiar atmosphere, but that was really, really good. And also the riverboat party together with Lothar.
A lot of nice memories,
yeah,
I see.
A lot of friends.
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's talk about sports a little bit, Stefan. We have a test match coming up against Marseille on Friday. Will you be at the FC Bayern campus?
I will be. I will be the host, but normal, just the announcements. Of course, the lineup and the goals. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Please. And as you said, it's a test match and no audience, of course. And let me tell you that I will never be used to an empty stadium. Because, of course, I do this job. I do my very best. It's like a very small piece of a puzzle back to normal situation. But I think, in my opinion, sports need an audience, each sport, especially football. You need the empathy, the support, the energy of the people watching you and supporting their stars and appreciate the efforts of the athletes. You know what I mean? And remember the Olympic Games. That's the principle. Yeah, that there are athletes and they do very good sports results, and all the people, yeah, you're my man. And that's not possible in this time, but what can I say? I'm waiting for better times.
We are all waiting for better times, but let's look back to those better times. Maybe we have a goal voting going on, looking for one of the most beautiful Champions League goals during the knockout stage. And yesterday, Bayern legend Roy Mackay went up against David Alaba. Yeah. Let's see who won in that duel. You like that one. David Alaba made it.
Yeah.
Yes.
With his left foot. Whoa.
Left foot. Today, we have, of course, another duel, but we're already moving on to the semifinals. And the first matchup in the semifinals is Arjen Robben versus Robert Lewandowski. Let's have a look. Look, Stefan, it's getting harder and harder to vote for these semifinals. We just showed you Arjen Robben versus Lewandowski. You can vote for your favorite goal. Just please go onto our either Twitter channel or our Instagram stories and you can vote. Please use the hashtag AudiFCBTour. Stefan, which one would you vote for?
That's, please don't ask me. It's the hardest decision, really, because each of these goals is overwhelming, in my opinion. I have a favorite, but I don't want to. I don't want to.
You don't want to influence. Yes,
please. It's your decision.
Very good. Okay, we have a really nice piece coming up for you guys. One of the players, Javi Martinez, he recently gave a surprise call to one of his fans in China, and the guy that he surprised is a really, really nice guy. And we have a video of what they talked about. Have a look.
China is one of the countries that I want to visit the most because I think it's amazing there. When I finish my career, because I need a long time to visit everything, I will visit for sure China, Japan, and all, not all the countries, but many Asian countries because I like the culture and everything.
Okay, you're always welcome to Xinyi.
Thank you. Someone told me that you play football as well.
Yeah, I play football, but as an amateur player. I play for our
university. Okay. The important is that you enjoy the game, so it doesn't matter where you play or which league or whatever. The most important about football is just to enjoy it. And which position you play?
I play as a goalkeeper.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You're a little bit crazy then, because all the goalkeepers are, you know, a little bit crazy.
Yes, when we are on the field, it's like we don't have to work a lot. But
I think
when we are practicing, we have to do many savings on the ground or something.
I think it's the most difficult position for me because you are always training not alone or with your colleague, just two or three, and you are always like separate from the team and they work so hard. So I think it's the most difficult position. Are you watching the Bundesliga now after the restart?
Yeah, I watch it. I watch like three or four Bundesliga games after the pandemic.
And, it's weird. It's weird to play play without fans because, the fans are for me one of the most important things in football, and it's sad, you know, to don't share these moments at this. For example, last Saturday in Berlin where we won the Pokal, we were very sad because we couldn't celebrate with the fans, and but hopefully we can again celebrate with them.
Yeah, of course. I think a game with fans is like a whole game.
Yeah.
Less atmosphere if there's no fans. Yes. But the DJ in Allianz Arena does a good job.
Stefan
shouting and playing the material. So
he's very good.
We can still feel it from the TV.
Yeah.
See, Stefan, they even talked about you.
Oh, yeah.
They said you're doing a great job, just bringing the atmosphere even to the people at home.
Yeah, the little puzzle piece. That's really nice to know, really, because that's the reason why I'm doing it. Mm-hmm. And that's the purpose,
Mm-hmm. Of course, with your job, you know all the players very well. Do you think that they enjoy when they can do videos like this as well?
Yes, of course. You only have to look in the faces and then you know that they have fun. When they did the shootout challenge here, between Robert Lewandowski a few days and so on. Look at the faces. They really have fun. They like to do these videos.
Mm-hmm. So, of course, you get to celebrate with the team as well when you do it at the Rathaus in Munich. For many times. Fortunately, for many times. Tell us a little bit how that is. Is that for you?
Oh, Kati, I'm always very exhausted after such a party. That's really when the job of the football players is done, my job is starting.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to be really nüchtern. How do you say I cannot drink
Sober.
I have to be sober. You know what I mean? I'm enjoying the situation. I want to be part of the party, but there must be one person, especially at the balcony at the Marienplatz. There must be one person who is
in control.
Really. Contenance, Monsieur Dame. And that's really hard for me. Of course, I enjoyed. You see the pictures here, right over here, always at the balcony when they became champion, German champion. But. But, yes, I have to concentrate in these moments, and later, of course, I can celebrate. Yeah.
Of course.
But they are really funny. It's always a pleasure. Yeah, especially Thomas. Yeah, oh, God, this guy, what he did to me the last years.
Hopefully, you will have another chance to celebrate this season. Yeah. But before that, the fan that you just saw talking to Javi Martinez, I had a chance to chat with him this afternoon, and I really want you guys to get to know him a little bit better. I hope I will pronounce his name right. His name is Fu Wan Che, and this is what he told me.
I'm from China. I'm a postgraduate student majoring in control engineering in Tongji University. I'm a Bayern fan. I also play football as a goalkeeper. So when it starts when I was six, that was 2002, FIFA World Cup, when Oliver Kahn did many great saves in that game. And even though I was little, I was truly impressed. So Oliver Kahn played for Bayern, therefore I become a Bayern fan.
Okay, he will be very pleased to hear that. What do you think is so special about FC Bayern?
Firstly, we play good. We always win and we win trophies. We are record meister. That's important for a club. But that's not all. Because it's more than just winning. We help small clubs during when they are in financial crisis. We help them by playing friendly match with them. And we help players even though they might not have another chance to play when they're in trouble. Like years ago, Breno and Deisler. So that's what's different from other clubs. Bayern is really a special club. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then recently you got a very special call in English from a guy with a heavy Spanish accent. How was that for you?
Yeah, that's you're referring to my phone call with Javi Martinez.
Exactly.
Yeah. He's really kind. He's really kind and patient to us fans. And during the 10-minute talk, I really feel good. I feel like we're friends. That's how I feel.
That's very nice. Do you have any other favorite players besides Javi Martinez on the team right now?
Yeah, in the team, Manuel Neuer, of course, because we are both captains and we are both goalkeepers. They played for, Manuel Neuer played for Bayern for such a long time, and he helped the team when the situation gets really tough. He saves penalties, saves goals from the goal. Yeah, so he's really responsible, and he's my role model.
Very nice. Unfortunately, you know, due to the COVID-19 situation, the team was unable to go to China this year. But there's also an Audi digital summer tour in China, and there's also a show every day. Do you watch that?
Yeah, I watch it.
And how do you like it?
For several times. I think it's really good. It's a great chance for us fans to communicate with the club and so we can know more about Bayern and the players in Bayern.
So as you know from the tour, the team is in preparation for the Champions League, of course. What do you think? How are the chances for FC Bayern to win it all this year, this season?
I think we have a great chance to win the triple. Because now our players are in great condition and our coach, Hans-Dieter Flick, he knows how to put the team together, so I have good faith. Even though recently Benjamin Pavard is injured, we still have other great players. So I have faith and we will win the Champions League this year.
Okay, very nice. You know, somebody told me, and I actually was a witness of it myself, that you are an outstanding singer as well, and you know the Bayern anthem by heart. Would you do us a big favor and give us a taste of your singing, please?
Okay, then I'll sing Tages voller Sonne.
Okay.
Diese Tage voller Sonne, voller Licht, OFCB. Und die Zeiten großer Sieger, voller Glück, OFCB. Du warst auf allen hohen Gipfeln, die Triumphe ungezählt. Diese Tage voller Sonne, FCB.
Wow, that was amazing. If you ever want to do a CD or a new song for FC Bayern, please go ahead and send it to us, because that was really amazing. How long did it take you to learn that?
It takes me like 3 days, 3 days, because this song is a kind simpler than Ständerstudenz. Ständerstudenz took me like 5 days or something.
Okay. Well, maybe next time we talk to each other, you can do Ständerstudenz, okay? You know, I have a guest today in the studio. His name is Stefan Lehmann. You, of course, know who that is. Do you have a question for him, maybe?
Okay, so hello, here Lehmann. We fans, we are really impressed by your voice and we're inspired. We like your voice a lot. So my question is, which home game impressed you the most during your career, and why?
That was a very nice question. It was so nice talking to you today. Thank you for being such an amazing FC Bayern fan. Please extend it to your whole teammates and the whole family over there in China. And hopefully one day you'll come to visit us here in Munich, okay?
Okay. Thank you. Thank you a lot. Bye-bye.
Such a nice guy, Stefan, right?
Yeah, really.
And great singer.
A great singer. Hey, and so really, it's so difficult. Yeah, in German, and really perfect, without any accent.
And he had a question for you towards the end.
Yeah.
So your favorite home game.
Yeah, that's... We already talked about it at the beginning of the show. Of course, this match against Wolfsburg with the 5 goals of Robert Lewandowski, but there are many others. I remember the year when the FC Bayern won the triple, 2013, with Jupp Heynckes as our coach. There was a half final between FC Barcelona. It was in the first match FC Bayern won in Stadio Nou Camp. 3-0, I guess, and then in the home match, 4-0. It was a big football party, and so it will always stay in my mind, yeah. That was one of my favorite matches.
Nice. We have another video for you guys. Manuel Neuer, he took a ride in a brand new Audi e-tron. He also picked up Javi Martinez and Lucas Hernandez, and they also chatted a little bit, asked some questions, and here are the highlights of this video.
Besonderes Fahrzeug. Coming from training now, and we are together in the new e-tron. You like the car?
Yeah, it's bigger. Yeah.
100% electric and very quiet.
RS7 is schon car. Very schnell. Me, I prefer the RS7. It works for the family and my son, for example, is very comfortable and very security.
So I can nicht him personally, so I only watch him on TV. You know, he's the kind of player who you enjoy watching, and I think it's gonna help the team a lot with his skills, and we can't wait to see him on the pitch. Manu, so it's your 8th Bundesliga in a row.
Yeah.
Pretty good, huh? How was the feeling? Was good?
Yeah, the feeling is great. Yeah, I think it's the same to you.
Yeah.
So we are happy.
AGL is amazing.
Yeah.
8 years ago, you were 16 years old.
Yeah.
Really, it's so difficult to score a goal against him that it makes me so annoying, really.
His skill is with his head.
Because I'm very intelligent player.
That was a very nice video. If you want to see it in full length, as well as any other video of this tour, please go on over to our YouTube channel and you can, of course, watch it all. And if you want to participate, talk to us, ask questions, please always use the hashtag AudiFCBTour and also hashtag MirSanFamily. Stefan,
yeah.
It was a pleasure to talk with you today. I did not know you didn't miss a single game during those 25 years. That's
home
amazing.
Matches, of course, yeah.
Tomorrow, we will have a very special guest sitting right there. Mr. President himself, Herbert Heiner, will visit
really?
Me tomorrow. Yes, I'm very Herbert. Excited. Also, we will talk to Chris Richards, who also, you know, he also gained his spot on the second team, but maybe he will make it to the first team sooner or later. And then we will talk to Georg Fiedler. He is the chairman of the biggest FC Bayern fan club outside of Germany. Mm. Where that fan club is, it's in Mexico. And I will give you a little tip. If you head over to Instagram in the stories, there's a quiz where you need to answer the question. So you're welcome. And then also, we will have a video with Manuel Neuer and the Mexican national team goalie, Guillermo Ochoa. Join us tomorrow. Now, Stefan, are you thirsty?
Yes,
I'm a little
thirsty. Please, yeah.
Yes. I think that's Albert,
the main reason
we would
why
love
I'm joining
for you.
You know, Kati,
to bring us
that
the biggest
is the
joy
main
of
reason
this.
Why I'm joining
yes.
this show. Thank you, Alberto.
Best
the
way to end the show. Thank you so Kati. Much for watching. See you tomorrow. Prost,
thank you.
Stefan.
Thank you all for watching and looking forward to win the Champions League in Portugal in a few weeks. FC Bayern
Fingers
Munich.
Crossed.
Thank you. Bye.